Hello everybody, welcome back to another Blender Made Easy tutorial. Today we're in Blender and we're going to be creating that really cool light bulb wireframe picture that you saw at the beginning of the video. We're going to be modeling the light bulb and then we're going to be adding a wireframe modifier to it and then some texturing and some lighting, and that'll be it. And maybe a little bit of compositing, we will see. But let's get started. This is going to be a pretty easy tutorial. It's not going to be too difficult to make the light bulb, so just follow along and you will do great. Alright, delete the cube, and then we're going to be adding in a background image. So press N to open up the properties, click on background images, and add it. And this is just a image I found off of Google, right here. Let me just see here. This one right here. Let me go into front view real quick by pressing 1 on the number pad, then 5. And there we go, there's our picture. Alright, I just brought the size down, and that should be good. Just set it to 5. There we go. Okay, so now, let's add in a cylinder. This is what we're going to be using as our base to model the light bulb. And then just scale it down a little bit, and then place it right about here. And if you ever get stuck on what key I press, just look down right here and it will show you. If I press S, it will see S right there. Alright. Now press Z to go into wireframe mode and then scale it down until it fits right about there. It doesn't have to be perfect, this is just like a reference image. We're not copying the exact thing. Go into edit mode and then alt right click on one of these loops to select the entire thing. That's a shortcut that you can use. If you alt right click, you can select loops. There we go. And then just bring it down to about there. Alright, then extrude by pressing E and then scale out. Extrude and scale out. This is what we're going to be doing to create the light bulb. Just keep doing this. Just get the basic shape right about there. Scale. Doesn't have to be perfect, like I said. Just make it look pretty nice and smooth. All right, and then at the top, we're going to scale it in one more time. Extrude right there, scale it all the way, and then at the top we're going to press S, 0, and enter. Then click W and click remove doubles, and that will get rid of all the unnecessary vertices, and now there's only one vertice right there, one vertice. Alright, maybe we'll just bring that down a little bit. There we go, perfect. Now let's go to the bottom and finish this. This part's pretty easy. All we're going to have to do is extrude out, scale it in, just like that, extrude, scale it in, and extrude one more time. Perfect. There we go. Cool. Maybe, hold on, this one. Yeah, that looks better. Okay, now let's add the wireframe modifier. So just bring this tab out just a little bit and click on the wrench, click add modifier, and wireframe. There we go. There's our wireframe. This modifier is really cool. You can do a lot of cool stuff with it. And you don't have to just replace the entire thing. You can click uncheck this mark and then it just keeps that just like that, but for this tutorial I'm gonna leave that on. Alright, set this thickness to 0.03. That's probably good, maybe a little bit more. Yeah, that's fine right there. Alright, and then also I think I want a couple of vertices right here. So go into edit mode, hit Control R and do 3 loop cuts, and you can do that with the scroll wheel. Click, click, and then go out of edit mode. There we go. Cool. Now let's add the material for this, but first we have to switch over to cycles and then click new material. This one we're going to be adding in a mix shader, so click mix shader, and the first one is emission and the second one is glossy, because we want that like light but also glass reflectiveness, you know. Alright, set the factor to 0.2, I think it was, and then bring this down to let's see, do we want it all the way? Yes, bring it all the roughness all the way down, like that. Cool, and then also you can set the color just a little bit of a yellow tint. We don't want it too strong, but just a little bit of a yellow to get the warm look. Very cool. Alright, so now let's split the window. Just like this, split this out and change it to node editor. No, not the text editor, node editor. Awesome. Okay, let me just go like that. Okay, now let's do the wood. and the texture is in the description, so you can go grab that. And hold on, I think I'm going way too fast. I think I should slow down a little bit. Okay, so press Shift A and add in a plane. And this is what we're going to be using to have the wood floor. Alright, go into front view by pressing 1, and then also we don't need the background image, so you can just click the X right there, that will get rid of it. Bring this down to the bottom right there. You can zoom in with the scroll wheel, shift, middle mouse to go like that, zoom in, and right there. Alright, and press S to scale it, and just go pretty big. It doesn't really matter how big you go because we're not going to be seeing the outside, so whatever, just right about there is fine. Next, we're going to UV unwrap this and then apply the texture. So go into edit mode and click U and click unwrap. Now let's switch over to the UV image editor and scale this up. Right about there, we'll redo it later in just a second. First we have to apply the texture. So click new, and then we're gonna be doing a little bit of stuff in here. So keep the diffuse, and we're gonna add in a mix shader. Right there, mix shader, and then add in a glossy right there. Cool. And apply that. We're going to set the factor to about a point. Yeah, 0.1 is fine. Set the roughness to 0 because we want this wood to be kind of reflective, like it's a little bit wet. And then we're going to add in the texture. So press Shift A, texture, image texture right there. Cool. Add that in and click open. And let me just find out where that is, right here. We're going to be using this texture, and all of it is in the description, so go grab it. There we go. And then we're going to add this to the displacement on the material output, and that will give it some bump. Very cool. So let's see what this looks like. Oh, that's actually a pretty good size already. I don't know if I have to scale it up. Because if it was, let me just show you real quick, go into the UV image editor. First it was like this, and this is way too big. So I scaled the UV image up, and the texture became smaller. Cool, I think I'm gonna, actually maybe a little bit more, right there. Yes, that looks pretty good. Next we're gonna be adding the brick texture. And what we can do is just Shift D on this plane, and then rotate it by 90 degrees. Just like that, and then grab it on the Y and bring it back to right about there. Very cool. Let's go back to the node editor, and then all we have to do is just add a new material, and let's name this one brick, and then switch it out. So click the little X, open, find out where you put your texture, and this one's in the description as well, and there we go. And it should already have the bump just like that. Sweet. Okay, next thing that we're going to be doing is positioning the camera. Actually, we don't need this lamp right here, so you can delete that. Let's go into the camera view by pressing 0 on the number pad. Now let's rotate it. Hold on, there we go. Grab it. There it is. Rotate it and position it over here. Go like this, bring it down, zoom out a little bit. And I did that by pressing G and then middle mouse, and you can zoom in and out like that. Right about there. Okay, that's pretty good. Now let's make this lay on the ground. Actually, I probably should have done that before I moved the camera, but whatever, it's fine. So right click on it to select, and then rotate it right about there. Bring it down by pressing G and then Z, just like that. Very cool. And then let's rotate it a little bit so it's at an angle. Awesome, let's see how that looks. That is looking pretty cool. Let's right click on the camera again, and also we don't need this anymore, so you can close that tab. G, middle mouse to bring it back. Move it over here, right about there. That looks pretty cool. And let's see what this looks like by pressing Shift Z. Nice. That's looking pretty cool. You got some like glow right there. I like that. Let's set the world to a black and see what that looks like. There we go, look at that. That looks pretty sweet. Alright, so let's duplicate this, the light bulb, a couple more times and just add it into the background. So press Shift D and then move it over here. And then maybe just rotate it a little bit so it's not the exact same. Shift D over there, rotate it all the way around, place it right there, and let's see what that looks like. Shift Z to go into rendered view. Look at that. That looks pretty sweet. Okay, I want to add some blur to the background. So right click on your camera and then go over to the camera settings and come down to depth of field and click cylinder 1 because this is the first cylinder that we added. And then change it to f-stop and set it to about a 0.2. That should give it some nice depth of field, maybe check high quality. So let's come over to your render settings and do a little bit more changing over here. So click sampling and the render, let's go 200. And the clamp, I like to set this to about a 3 on each of these. And what the clamp does, if there's some fireflies in the image, it gets rid of them. That's what the clamp does. And fireflies are little like white specks of light that are throughout the image and it doesn't look very good. So that helps. And then also if you come to the light paths, you can uncheck these and that will get rid of them as well. Cool, I think that's it. Let's see what it looks like. Click render and let's check it out. All right, there we go. It is finished and that looks pretty cool. I like it. The blur in the background looks pretty good. The bricks look pretty realistic. It's got some bump and the floor isn't that bad at all. I think it turned out pretty nice. Let me just see. I think if you could use a little bit more sampling, maybe around 500, I think it would look better. But I don't have time for that. I'm going to go straight into the compositing. Alright, let's click on Use Nodes and get rid of a couple of these windows because they're just in the way. Alright, what a shortcut that you can do is if you hold Control and Shift and left click. Wait. Click Backdrop. There we go. Then it will add in the image and we can see it. Okay, so the first thing that I want to do is add in a fog glow around the lights. So just place a light right there and then bring it into the composite and change it to fog glow and then bring the threshold down till you can start to see it. There we go, you can start to see it. All right, that's probably good right there. I like it. And next I want to add in some color, color balance right there. Plug it in and bring it into the composite. All right, let's bring this one over into a warmer color. Nice, just very lightly because it makes a big difference. All right, one more right about there. Let's see what that looks like. Cool. And then also I would like to add a vignette. There's a little bit right here, but I think I want to add it a little bit more. So the focus is entirely on the light bulb. All right, so how to add a vignette. It's pretty simple. All we have to do is add in a couple of nodes. The first one is a lens distortion and change the distort to 1. Next, add in a blur node right here and take the output of the lens distortion and plug it into the top input of the blur and then change it to fast, click relative, click Y and change both of these to 20%. Next, we're going to add in a mix node. So come over here. Where is it at? Mix. Wow, they changed the order of these. Mix node right there. Plug it in there. Take the output, plug it into the bottom, and then you can see, you should see, there you go, just like that. And change it to multiply. There we go. Look at that. That looks pretty cool. I think it's a little too much, so change it to about 0.8. Yeah, 0.8 looks pretty cool. Alright, there we go. And then how to save it is go back to the default view and click here, viewer node. Awesome! There is our image. That looks pretty sweet. I think we did pretty cool. I think we did pretty good. That's the word I'm looking for. Alright, thank you all for watching. If you learned something new, if you made a cool image, tell me in the comments below, link me a website or wherever you post it on social media, whatever. And yeah, that's gonna be it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next tutorial. Goodbye.